welcome to the vlog and welcome to my life. Today is going to be a bit of a roller coaster, but we're gonna see how it goes. I'll explain in a bit, but good morning. It's currently just past 8 and I've done my whole morning routine and I'm ready to start the day. I don't think we're supposed to have the best weather today, but I'm determined to have literally the best day. I also have so much to update you on. Look at my gorgeous flowers that my mum bought me when my parents came down at the weekend. I need to put fresh water in actually, but they look so cute in the jug. They love their little bedroom setup, so I'm so glad that I did that. I've just moved the flowers from there back downstairs. But yeah, I'm trying to think what else I have to show. Oh, I have so much to show you. One sec. So I don't know if you remember, but in the last vlog, I was talking to you about how I really wanted this mirror from Soho Home, but I was waiting for Black Friday, but at the same time, I didn't know if I should wait until Black Friday because I didn't know if they're going to put it in the sale because it's one of those things that miraculously disappears when there's any kind of discount. So I literally went on my laptop the next morning, like 6 a.m. when I woke up, and they had their Black Friday like sale on. Don't know why already, but it was like 25% off, which it was last year. And I was like, oh my gosh, is it in stock? And it was. So I placed an order, and then when you spend a certain amount, you got a free gift. And this is what I got. I could choose between, I gave you a choice, which I thought was really good. These like champagne glasses or these tumblers. And I just thought these were so sweet. And it's also something that I don't really have. I don't have any glass sets. Aren't they so sweet? So I thought that was very exciting, but I placed an order for some bar stools, but I got, I don't even know, like height wise. There was two different ones. I got the lower one, so I'm going to test it and see because these are too high. And so yeah, I ordered a couple of those. I only have two in stock, so I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do it. I know they come back in stock periodically, it's fine. And then yeah, I got two mirrors. I got a bathroom bin, a couple of bathroom bins actually, but only one turned up. And then another mirror, but the other mirror that turned up is just not the size that I thought it was. I obviously measured, but it just is just so consuming. I think because it's so heavy and big, it's just not what I wanted. So yeah, I tried to return that and DPD wouldn't accept it. So I'm like in the shop with this huge freaking parcel and they're like, no. But thankfully I emailed Soho Home and they were like, we'll send someone, don't worry about it. And I was like, oh, that's so kind, thank you. But I also got this from Amazon. Okay, right, wireless. How good is that? And you can do like different tones of light. Oh, I also had these lights changed. Let me know if it looks better. I thought it always looked very pink in here and it really annoyed me when I was editing. I was like, we need to fix this. But yeah, isn't this so sweet? I think this was £17. How crazy is that? I just randomly came across it and I was like, that is a gem. But today is going to be a good day, a weird day. I have some filming to do this morning, so I need to like do my makeup. And then I'm heading into town for a meeting, which is going to be really, really good. And yeah, I love days like this. It's a day where I get to be super creative and just talk about what my plans are for the rest of the year and for like the first quarter of next year. I'm making some really big changes and there's some really big changes happening that I also have no control over, which is, I think, really, I don't know, testing. Like, that's when you choose to kind of grow with things or not. And it's an exciting time, but also a scary time. I also found my pink lampshade. I feel like I was saying to you in the last vlog that I knew I had this somewhere, but I didn't know where. So I just put it on my Pookie lamp for now, just the floor lamp, and it looks so sweet. I mean, I might have to wait until later to show you it properly, but isn't that adorable? And it's just next to the sofa, which obviously has a blanket on because the dog loves the sofa. I'm undecided whether I'm allowing it or not yet. So this is the temporary situ. Do you allow your dogs on your furniture? Like, what's your stance with that? At the minute, he's allowed on there if he's invited. He won't just get up on his own, which is obviously really good. And I do love having a cuddle with him. But at the same time, I'm like, is it going to like ruin the furniture? Or if he has muddy feet, I can't be mad at him if he gets on the sofa and I don't realize he has muddy feet, you know? I would love to know like what your stance is with that. So I started to order some Christmassy bits from Amazon. Look at this. I mean, along with the lamp, you kind of get the vibe of what I'm shopping for right now. Actually, I also got some ribbons for presents. I thought this was actually very my style when it comes to wrapping. I love very like traditional looking presents, like the velvet, and I love that it's all all kind of cursive. I think it's beautiful. And yeah, just the candle, which is very messy. And I guess it is damaged, to be honest. A lot of them are chipped off, but I quite like that look. But yeah, I'm gonna get ready to go and film. I'm gonna do my makeup. And then I need to head into town. I'm also in the process of booking a nail appointment, especially because of my event on Thursday. I need to get this sorted out. I was having a break and Freddie was saying to me, she's like, why are you having a break? And I was like, I don't know why I'm having a break. I just feel like I should have a break. And she was like, I did exactly the same thing. She was like, it makes no difference. But she did say I needed to try this nail conditioner that I didn't actually try. But in all honesty, I had the worst nails in the whole entire world. That even if I took like a year off gels, my gels would still only last like 2.5 weeks. They would never last. I feel like I need to try something like builder gel or something like that, but I'm afraid of the commitment. I also love that I can remove my own gel when I need to, and I can do it in a damage-free way. But yeah, I'm gonna get ready to film and then do that, which I'm just, oh, I'm so ready just sitting. I mean, I'm chatting to you right now, but you know what I mean. I'm ready to like sit and chat. And then yeah, I'll head into town for my meeting. I briefly said in the last vlog, but the event that I'm hosting on Thursday is actually with YouTube and Vogue, which is very exciting. And then the next day is actually my 10-year YouTube anniversary, which is wild. Like a decade on this platform. Lots of things are changing. So it's kind of crazy how this is my 10th year and it's like, okay, this is when it's time to make some like big decisions or make some like life changes. But the event's gonna be really good. It's all about women in YouTube. And yeah, because it happens to be the night before my 10-year YouTube anniversary, I'm hosting it with YouTube and Vogue. And we're gonna talk about my journey, about my history on, you know, on YouTube, and I don't know. I'm feeling like very, actually when I like say it out loud, very emotional. There's a lot of things in my life right now that are changing. And obviously change is so healthy, but I think it can take time to kind of process change. The last two nights I've gone to bed and I have like started to feel myself panic. You know, like, I don't know if anyone's ever had panic attacks as they fall asleep, but that's when I seem to get them in adult life. Not when I was a teen, but in adult life, that's when they seem to creep up on me. And I really have to kind of lay there and like breathe and say my affirmations and do whatever I can to like calm myself down. And two nights in a row I have gone to bed like that, and it's really not good for me. But I know it's because there's so much change coming, and I'm okay with the change and I'm excited about what comes next. It's just the actual like thing of it's happening, and today is one of the really big days, so I'm sure I'll feel better when I go to bed tonight. But I can't like force my subconscious to be okay with something. I, you know, like, I truly, you feel how you feel, and I'm just kind of like dealing with that. But let's go and get ready to film. Oh yeah, look at my cute little SD card holder. What I try and do is keep the ones the right way around, this is the way around it goes, that are empty, and then the upside down ones are the ones that I need to like take things off because I filmed. In reality, there should be nothing on any of them because I should be organized enough that my files are all organized onto external hard drives, but life gets in the way and doesn't happen. But it's fine because I will do that at some point, but when it's dark, because we're not wasting daylight on this. I've just finished filming and I've got approximately 30 minutes to get ready to go and see my team. But I just realized I was wearing this dress last time I saw them, so I want to put something else on. Don't know what. Let's go and have a look at the new InReal. I moved it into the gym temporarily. So this is today's dress. Obviously the ties are undone, so it does sit tighter, which I love the fact it has the ties. I would buy this in every color that it came in. I genuinely feel amazing when I wear it. But yeah, I can't wear this. Well, I mean, I can, it's fine, but why would I? Let's try something else. So this is on my new InReal. I have these cute little sets, which are actually Amazon, would you believe it? Obviously can't wear shorts. Oh, this dress, which I'm deciding whether I keep or not. Isn't that just so insanely beautiful? I'm thinking maybe Christmas Day dress, but I don't know if I should go for something like a different vibe, because I go for like velvet and cutesy doll like every year, but is it time to grow up? I don't know, but I do love this, and it would be the final style of dress like this that I do ever buy, because it's like a keep forever kind of dress. I don't know, let me know what you think. I could do an all nude situ with this blazer, maybe. I could wear my mango, like nude, no, it's not nude, but like creamy skirt, and maybe a knit or something. I'm gonna have a bit of a play and I'll let you know. Please ignore the undone shoes, because as soon as I finish showing you, I will be taking them off, because I'm, yeah, not a shoes in the house person. But I've got my Burberry trench, my And Other Stories knit, Reformation skirt, and then I'm gonna do my sambas and my cutesy little longchamp, which I might change, actually, yeah, I'm gonna change for a crossbody, because I'm going to take a tote bag with me as well, just in case I have any posts to bring back. I mean, I love this and it has everything that I need, but I actually don't need a bag like this. I can just take a little one that I can put over my, you know, over my body that will go under my jacket. I'm a bags under the jacket kind of person. But yeah, what do you think?
I mean, it's very simple, and I don't tend to wear this jacket out very much unless I know I'm going straight somewhere and straight back, because I love it and I want to keep it in like the best condition. I would have usually gone for my green trench, but I need to wear these things. I can't just tell myself I don't need to wear them.
Yeah, I'm upset. I've said it's gonna be a roller coaster of a day. Well, I just finished my meeting. We have some news.
Oh, I'm gonna bend down.
That's yeah,
that's not a look. I'm going. Bye. No.
He's leaving me.
I'm sorry.
No, it's not funny. Don't, I'm gonna cry.
Oh, you're really, I got you a card.
No, you didn't. I was gonna get you and I was gonna get a sorry for your last card. Oh, I did already send him a card, but I was gonna get you a sorry for your lost funeral card, but I decided it was inappropriate.
That's it for me. That's who. Yeah, I'm sorry. If you think it's too much, you don't have to open it now.
Oh, don't, because it's gonna make me cry.
Yeah, it might, and it might make me cry, so that's why I can't look at it. Read it now.
It's been 6 years, guys, and he's going on to amazing things.
Oh, definitely don't read it if you're already crying. Don't.
It's really sad, but it's really wonderful. Yeah. I'm so happy for you.
You're gonna be amazing. Oh, I'm gonna be.
We can be friends now.
Yeah.
I
will. I don't say bad words.
I'm home and I look very windswept. I've been here for a bit, but the gas engineer's been here, so I couldn't talk to you. But I got my nails done. What do you think? I got Midnight Swim back on, ready for my event on Thursday. And oh my gosh, I was sat in the nail salon, literally with my nails drying under the gel machine, and well, curing. And like silently crying, but I'm like, don't cry. I'm like, what can I think about that's not this that's gonna stop me crying? But I feel very windswept. Oh my goodness. I actually don't know how there's any like shape in my hair anymore because I got honestly drowned, but I'm absolutely ravenous. I got in and demolished a pot of cottage cheese. I was like, what can I grab and just get out of their way, out of the kitchen? And that's what I went for in the end. But it's still quite early. It's literally like 5 p.m. I have small bits to do, but I really want to eat first. And then I think later tonight, when the rain stops, we'll go out for a nice little evening stroll. That's been like my favorite thing to do since he's been here. It's really nice to go out in the evening and not walk solo. It's actually really, really nice. I also picked up my post from the office, but I was a bit distracted, you know, in floods of tears. But I have this dress in my PO box, and it's from a brand called The Roofer's Granddaughter. And they're basically saying they saw my video talking about shopping at kind of smaller, slower, local British businesses. And she just thought this would suit me. And oh my goodness, isn't this just the most kind gesture? I seriously need to have a look into this brand because this feels so weighty and so gorgeous. I can't wait to try it on. And it looks like the length of dress that I love. And then I actually got another parcel, which I bought this one from Etsy, and the brand is called Kiss My Vase. And how gorgeous is this? So basically Lydia, who this is her brand, she DM'd me on Instagram. She's like, I want to send you one of my vases. And I was like, well, I'm gonna be really difficult. I have a request because I don't think this exists and I would love one, but I would please let me buy it. So this is what she created for me. How gorgeous. I basically just wanted a vase that had holly on it, but like in a cute little ditzy way, but big enough that you could still tell that it was holly. I think these are going to look so cute. Wait, this is like the vibe I'm thinking. I can put my little mini Grayson Thorn bunches in them. Oh my goodness. Obviously a more festive bunch of flowers. Like some reds and things like that, but look how festive they look. I am over the moon. I'll pop her Instagram in the description box, but genuinely so over the moon. I think they're just cute little styling pieces for Christmas. Then they don't look too obvious, and I love that. Let's see what we have in the fridge. I have some mozzarella. I have another pot of cottage cheese. Actually, the M&S cottage cheese, top tier. I have some chakan. I've just had a lovely shower and you can see the remnants of the food that I grabbed earlier. I'm so emotional. I didn't expect to be this emotional. I'm very matter of fact with things. And normally I'm like, if something happens, I'm just a bit like, okay, it happened for a reason. Like being upset is not gonna do anything, but I'm sad. I'm gonna stop or I'm gonna cry again. But basically I'm very proud of him and reading that card right now is not the right time. So place an order on Zara Home. I have been on the hunt for the perfect Christmas PJs. I've ordered maybe 4 pairs and they've just not been right. 2 of which were Amazon ones, which everyone was like, oh my gosh, they're so great, I got them. No, they
horrible. I'm also 5'10", so if pajamas, how are you supposed to return this if this is not right, if I have to rip the bag to get into it? Being 5'10", finding pajamas that fits is, it's a little bit tricky, Coz. Like, how do I even do that? Okay, so this first set came as an actual set, and I mean, they all sell out and go back into stock so regularly, so I can't even remember what size I managed to get hold of. I think it was a medium. I mean, this doesn't even have the Zara label in it, which isn't giving me much hope. Okay, yes, a medium. And the reason I was sold on these is the little velvet hem, and it's the same around the collar and on the pocket and on the sleeves, and I just thought that attention to detail was beautiful. So I got those. They're the Christmas edition pajamas. I got them in a medium. Let's try them on at some point in this vlog, but I'm sure they'll be absolutely fine. They look, I mean, they don't look like they're gonna be super long, but they look fine, and that's good enough for me. And then I also got this set, which doesn't come as a set, you have to buy individually. So I managed to get the trousers in a medium, which I'm so glad about. They are little holly ones, which is just so exciting. I just don't, oh, why have I got two pairs? I definitely didn't order that. I need to figure that out. But yeah, they come individually. I think I got this in a small. Oh, tell me it's not the cutest thing you've ever seen. That actually looks perfect. So exciting. I have had the same pair of Christmas pajamas from Abercrombie for the last like 5 years, so I decided it was time to get some new ones, and I just love the little holly pattern. Isn't that just so cute? But I obviously need to send one pair of trousers back. I don't know how I did that. I will have to try them on before I start, you know, ripping tags out, but aren't they just the cutest? I'm going to put my little holly vases up here. The only things that are on here are things that I need to put away, really. There's no kind of rhyme or reason to it. But let's move these. I don't know how I'm going to decorate or what I'm going to put in them, but I mean, maybe I could get some holly to go in them. That would look really cute, but I do think they are adorable. I'm just back from my walk, and I looked on my Zara order, and I did order two pairs of pajama bottoms, so I don't really know why, but I'm just going to bag one of these back up. I am going to keep this parcel in hand though, just in case the others don't fit. Honestly, so much better. It might still look mad cluttered, but it looks way less cluttered than it did. This is my pile to take upstairs. I've got my bag. And then I freshly washed my tea towels, which are my gorgeous William Sonoma ones. Everything over here is pretty fine. And then my gift guide collection is building. I keep picking up things here and there, and I just think it looks really, really good. And yeah, this is all ready to be, you know, put away in the morning when it's dry. And then we have the pile of stuff down here, which I just, let's just not even talk about that. I mean, I just had to, but isn't this the most beautiful dress you've ever seen in your whole entire life? The length is perfection. Reformation, take note. This is the length of dress you need. It fits like an absolute glove. And I guess you can wear it like this, or you could even, if you wanted to, wear it like this. It's very bridal, isn't it? I think this is absolutely beautiful. And the scrunchie. I mean, I kind of love it with the sleeves kind of ruched on my shoulders, but oh, the scrunchie. Stop it. I'm in love. And I love that it's actually got a gorgeous shape to it at the back. I don't like it when dresses have those stretchy things. I love this. I just know whenever I wear this out, I'm going to get a million questions on it. Actually, I kind of love it like this too. And with the sleeves kind of pushed up, I feel like it's very versatile for a plain white dress. Feels so princessy. They're literal perfection. I'm so glad I managed to get the trousers in a medium. And also, I was worried the top was going to be too small because it was a small, and I really like my pajamas super oversized, but I actually think this is perfection. So the top is a small, bottoms are a medium, and I actually have them where they're supposed to go on my hips, and they're long enough. And obviously you can wear them kind of lower waist and they hit the floor, but to be honest, I think I'll probably wear these out with a cute knit and then like some fluffy Taz Uggs. I think that's just, obviously that's such a look right now, and I really like that. Also, I'm loving the chunky scrunchie. I feel like I would love one of these in like a velvet color. I don't know how I feel about it with a half updo, but maybe with a pony? I'm leaning at a very awkward angle right now to try and see in this mirror. Okay, let me try the tartan ones on. They're slightly giving clown because of the collar, but I actually kind of love that. But what I would say is you need to size up. I'm a UK 6 and these are a medium, which means there's two sizes smaller that I could have bought. There's no way way. I don't know about you, but I move in my sleep. Again, I've got these on my hips, but I think these are slightly shorter, so I would probably wear these. Then that looks a bit silly, doesn't it? Maybe I would have to. I mean, not that anybody's going to see me wearing this besides me. Actually, and you guys. But yeah, these are really sweet. I'm going to keep both pairs. And let's try the scrunchie as like a pony and not half up. Where can I get a scrunchie like this, but like a navy velvet one, or even like a green velvet one? I was looking at Hill House Home at their hairbands, and I think they're really cute. I definitely would love some more hair accessories. I literally have that one hairband that I have, and I wear it, but like I wear it to do my makeup now. And you know when you demoted something, and I just don't really think I can promote it back. Yeah, I actually love, but it definitely needs to be like a wintry vibe with this. I love how girly that looks. Honestly, I hate a ponytail, but this makes the ponytail look so cute. Oh my gosh.
You'll notice I've stopped crying, which is wonderful. But we have a new product alert. This is from SkinCeuticals. It's their HA Intensifier, and I've been using it for maybe 5 days, I would say. And I keep reaching for it, so that must mean I really, really like it. I feel like, obviously, skincare, it takes time for you to see the results, but I think you know a lot from using it for a few days, whether you like the texture, you like how it leaves your skin. And then I feel like you give yourself a while to see if, like, there is impacts from it. But I really like this. Gosh, today's been a day. I knew today was going to be upsetting for me, and I've been, like, not thinking about it. When Craig told me, we had a bit of a cry, and then we kind of just pretended it wasn't happening, and obviously it is happening. And I don't know, it's tricky. I feel like it's amazing because the job that he's going into, without giving too much of his business away, it's not like he's going and doing the same job but with other people. He has this insane opportunity. He's got his dream job, and as his friend, I could not be more over the moon for him. But as his client and as his colleague for the past 6 years, I am heartbroken. So it's bittersweet. There's lots and lots of change happening in my world right now. And you know what? All it's doing is encouraging me to make more and more change, which is interesting because change used to really scare me, and although certain things about change still do make me feel a bit uneasy and do, I guess, still scare me, more than anything, it excites me now, because I think nothing changes unless you change, and the exciting things happen when you do open different doors and you meet new people and you work with new people. So I'm excited to see what this means for me, and there's so many other things going on in my life right now that are like huge changes, and I guess it's all just come in a flurry, hasn't it? Actually, that kind of sums up life. It's very much all or nothing, but I'm riding it, and I'm really enjoying it, and we're gonna see what happens. But yeah, I wanted to film today because I really wanted to document today's memory. I am so proud of you, Craig. I really, really am, and it's yeah, I don't even know really what to say. I love that I have this vlog to look back on to close that chapter together. I love that you have this vlog to look back on to close together, even though I know you don't even watch my vlogs anymore, because you make it really obvious. So not that you're actually gonna be watching this one. I've just come to do a 5 minute tidy up in my dressing room. So I'm going to love you and leave you. I really hope you've enjoyed today's vlog. As I was saying, it's really nice just to have today as a memory, as a little chapter close. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Good night.